Imagine if you were taking a hike through some beautiful country, and every turn of the trail was something more beauty and more beauty and more beauty and more astonishing scenery. Well, you've been going along this trail for a long time, and yet every turn there's something even better, something even more amazing, like wow, wow. But as you go along, you get used to it. You get used to it. So if you compare what you're seeing now to what you saw when you started out, you might be overwhelmed, say this is too much. But if you look at it, say, well, this is more amazing than yesterday, and yesterday was more amazing than the day before and the day before, etc. But yet I'm getting used to all of this, then it's not so bad. It's not too much. It's not overwhelming. So what I've been finding is that every single day there's another huge breakthrough into something that's just truly astonishing. But it's not too much. It is not too much. Having walked along the path, you get used to it. You get used to it. It's more than before, but not too much for what I'm used to. So today is no different than yesterday in terms of breakthrough. It's just amazing what I discovered today. And if I can put it into words, the truth is way stranger than fiction, actually. The explanation for this world is way stranger than any fiction has ever been written, actually. Now, let's say you have a country A, and this country has a very powerful military, and they have an enemy, country B, let's say. And they're very afraid that country B is going to attack them and take them over. So they are developing all these defenses to prevent country B from coming in and taking them over. Now, country B is not doing anything at this point. You know, they're building up their military, I guess. And so country A says, you know what? We need to test our defenses to see if they work, if they're going to work. And obviously, if you have built up all these defenses, you're not going to be sure how well they work. So what does country A do? Country A says, okay, this is how we're going to do this. We're going to have what's called war games. And we're going to divide our military into two divisions, Division 1 and Division 2. So Division 1 is doing the defending, okay, doing the defending. Division 2 is doing the attacking. So what division, we want Division 2 to simulate an attack based on what Country B's military is designed to do. Okay, so Country A's Division 2 is going to simulate the attack, an attack that they feel would be coming from Country B. And then Country A's Division 1 is going to defend against that attack. And then they have observers, military observers, who observe and monitor the conflict and take notes and film it, and then after it's over, the exercise is over, everyone gets in a debriefing. They discuss, you know, what went right, what went wrong, and they evaluate their defenses that way. They evaluate their defenses. Well, it's no different, actually, than what's taking place with existence. Existence is actually spirit attempting to split its will into a separate will and create a separate creation that is separate from spirit, that is not spirit, actually. And so this is the basic premise of the situation. Now we have to integrate what I've just said about the defenses, because I discovered something extremely important about the situation here. What spirit is doing is it's trying to concoct a past for its presumed creation that will not be spirit, that will not recognize spirit as its creator. It will be a separate creation and will think that it came from something else. It was created from something else. So spirit is working on making this something else, this past, this universe of conflict and change and fragmentation and processes and dynamics and all this stuff. This is going to be the mirage of a past that is presented to the so-called new child. We'll call it a child is going to be born, but we believe a child will be born into this that will recognize this as its true home, that this is what created it. Okay, now this is all deception. It's all deception. Spirit cannot split its will, cannot create unlike itself. It's impossible. But Spirit believes it's possible by concocting this deceptive past to such a realistic extent that the presumed child will say, "Ah, this must be true. This must be my past. This must be where I came from." Okay, so Spirit has been working on this for a long, 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 long time, and is putting all its creative intensity effort into this. Now, there's two aspects of this. One is that Spirit is concocting this imaginary past for its imaginary child. Two, the second part that we're not, I haven't talked about yet, it's very important, is that Spirit realizes this is all deception. And it's very worried that its imaginary child in this realm of impermanence and death and doom and catastrophe and all this suffering, that somehow someone, a savior, will come to this child and tell it the truth about the situation. And the child will say, "Oh my gosh, this is all unreal. It was actually Spirit that created me. I'm eternal Spirit too." So Spirit says, "Wow, this is a huge problem." Because how am I going to stop the truth coming to find this child and telling the child this is the actual truth of the situation? Huge problem for Spirit. So Spirit says, "Okay, all right, let's work on this." So there's this other facet of this whole scheme, this prank really, as Spirit's playing on itself. It's this whole scheme is to have massive defenses against truth ever coming into this world, ever coming and being able to convey truth to the child when the child is quote unquote born here, which will never happen. There is no child, there is no pregnancy, nothing will ever be born, no life will ever be born out of non-life, as it were, out of death. But we're preparing for it. We're preparing for every contingency. Why make sure? So we have this massive defense system, which is an integral part of the scheme, which is designed to prevent Spirit from ever changing its mind and saying, "You know what? I think I want to tell my child that actually it's my true child, and it's not the child of all this time and space." See, because Spirit's thinking within it, it's like it might want to inform the child actually of its true heritage. And so Spirit's trying to defend against that possibility. Okay, it's very, very fertile territory to look at here. So just follow along. I'll try to explain this. So this massive defense system is in place to prevent this. But since there's no child yet, you know, Spirit says, "You know what? I want to make sure these defenses work. I want to make sure these defenses work." So the Spirit says, "How do I do that?" And the Spirit says, "Okay, I'm going to send my truth into this world. And I'm going to test out my defenses. I'm going to test out the defenses and see if they work. See how well they work, and then evaluate them. So that I can fix the stuff that doesn't work." And so, how does Spirit do that? It's very interesting. I call it the what Spirit does is it sort of seduces aspects of Spirit to do this. Now what happens is that when you get the quote-unquote goddess is part of this whole scheme. The goddess is part of, the Great Mother is part of this whole scheme that the Spirit's working on. And she says, "You know what? I'm going to give birth to a child in time and space, and yet this child will not know its true heritage. And would you please, I need volunteers to go into this world and prepare to tell my child the truth so it can know its true heritage." And she gives you this sob story about, you know, how the Spirit doesn't want the child to know its true heritage and all this, and "I please need volunteers." And so through this, Spirit gets volunteers, aspects of Spirit say, okay, I will come down into this world, and I will tell the truth that this is all bogus. The whole thing is complete. It's all a scam. This is your true heritage. Okay, but the goddess is two-faced. Two-faced. This is what we don't understand. Janus, the Janus goddess, two-faced. Because what she's really doing is getting, and what Spirit's really doing, is getting volunteers to come into this world, bringing truth, thinking that this is what Spirit wants. Spirit says, I've repented, I've remorse, I want to find out how can I tell my child that's going to be born, you know, the truth. But then the goddess has this massive defense system, goddess quote Spirit, designed to prevent those who come into this world from telling the truth. And all they're doing is they're actually testing their defense system out. That's what I discovered. This is what I discovered in my life, because I was one of those volunteers. Volunteered to come here to tell the truth to the world. And what I found out was totally bizarre. I found myself at every angle being thwarted. And I found that the goddess who's supposedly trying to help me is actually setting me up into situations where I can be attacked and really assassinated. And I became aware of this, and I said, this is very odd, what's going on? What's going on? I became very confused and frightened and freaked out. Many attempts have been made to assassinate me. Super subtle, clever attempts. Very clever attempts. To all look like an accident. And I got freaked out. I said, what's going on? I thought I was coming here to tell the truth and everything's supporting me in doing this. And yet, everything that happened is trying to thwart me and ruin my life and cause me to commit suicide and all of this. And I said, wow, where's the help? What is going on? So I finally have managed to put the whole thing together and understand what's going on. I'm just being used. I was just being used to test the defensive systems out. So in other words, here comes somebody who knows the truth about the situation, coming, wanting to tell the child, look, this is your true heritage, willing to speak the truth. And all these defense systems are designed to completely thwart that from happening, ruining your life, causing you to die, causing you to be so stressed out and freaked out, and nobody listening to pain, all this stuff. They're just testing their defense systems out, is all that's taking place. It's like, wow, the whole thing was being used. The entire situation was just being used to test the defense systems out. And of course, the goddess tells you that you're going to be a hero, that when the child is born, that you will be its savior, actually. The goddess says, there's a cruel spirit who doesn't want my child to know it's really divine, and can you please come in and liberate this? You'll be the one who tells us. And you say, oh, wow, I'll be a hero to the goddess, you know, and inform this child about his divinity. And you think, wow, I'm doing the best thing possible. It's a setup. It's a setup. You're being set up. I was set up and used. Absolutely used. It's the most amazing thing, because I became aware that there is this aspect that it was psychically setting me up, putting me in positions where I would have been killed if I hadn't have had intuition to sidestep it suddenly. And I said, well, why did you lead me into the situation telling me it was wonderful, wonderful, wonderful? And then I realized in hindsight it was a complete setup. And I said, what is going on? My whole life, I said, what is going on? I thought I came here to tell the truth. And it seems like all I'm being used to test out and evaluate the defense systems. It's like, but, you know, the goddess is so convincing in her story, you see. But she's lying, of course. She's two-faced. She wants to test. She's the aspect that gives the sob story. That convinces you to do this, you see. Uses all her beauty and, you know, the beautiful Dakini who can seduce you into thinking you're going to be a hero of the dream. All to test out the defense systems so Spirit can feel comfortable that there's no way the truth will ever get to this child, even if Spirit wants to get to it. The defense systems are so clever. The goddess is really a defense system of this whole plan. That's what I found out. She's two-faced. She's the one who is defending against truth in the world so that this imaginary child that Spirit is born of time and space will never hear the truth. Will never hear the truth. That's what the goddess is with us. So that's why she's so distracting. It's causing me to go this way and this way and get me off track this way and that way. I say, I thought you wanted me to tell the truth here. You know, what's going on? Is something wrong with me? Am I bad? You know, you start, get so confused, so unsettled, you know, like, wow. But the jig is up, the game is up, actually. Now, what's the remedy for all this? That also has come to me this morning. I'll give you a little chance to settle into this, what I just told you, because it is true. I have experienced it directly. My entire life I've experienced this. And it's been the puzzlement of puzzlements. I said, you know, wow, something is just being incredibly deceptive. And again, it is testing out the defense systems that are in place to prevent anyone from ever coming and telling that child, you know, that, you know what, you're actually an extension of spirit. You're divine. All this time and space crap, that was all a deception to deceive you. To think that was your past, that you came from this past, that you're a product of this past. It's all designed to prevent this from ever taking place. And so, what they say is the sooner our defenses are proved to be totally effective, the sooner the child can be born. This is the whole story they tell you. And they say the child has not been born yet because our defenses are not yet properly in place. So if you can just test these defenses out and we can determine that they work, then the child will be born. So in another way, you're thinking that you're the hero in allowing this child to be born, like a new creation to be born, by testing out these defenses. So that's in play also. And the truth is, of course, that no child will ever be born. So all these defenses are totally useless. There's nobody that needs to be told. There's no child that needs to be told, you see. All totally a waste of time, totally useless. So, what to do? And I came last night, I came up with it, and this morning it became clearer and clearer and clearer. What you do is you give the entire universe, everything, all action, you give it a break. You suspend it for an instant. Everything. Have all time stop for an instant. Everywhere. Simultaneously, concurrently. Not this and this and this like a process. Concurrent, total stoppage of everything, of this total scheme. Everything is suspended. Suspended animation for an instant like that. Everywhere. I started going over it this morning, all the different actions that would I want them to be suspended or not. And yes, yes, yes. And I started going through this massive inquiry into this and saw all these different actions and activities that are taking place in the world and situations, etc. And I said, yeah, suspend that too. Yeah, that's suspended too. Yeah, that's suspended too. Everything, take a break simultaneously. This is called the holy instant that Jesus talks about. As is necessary. And in that moment, what you say, what is it beyond this, all this activity? Is there something beyond that, you see? And we're afraid there's some abyss there. So, but what is it when everything, all this scheme, simultaneously frozen in place for an instant, nothing's happening. Nothing's happening at all. What then do you experience? What then do you experience? This is the question. I want to find out the answer to this. Now, the gurus have told us that what's there, but I'm not sure yet because you have to experience it yourself. But what Jesus tells, the holy instant, you will recognize being, the being that is always there, that is not affected by action of any type. No thoughts. When I mean action, all thoughts, all planning, suspended. Everything, thoughts, planning, reactions, emotions, defensive testing, trying to tell the truth, etc. All that suspended. And yeah, including trying to tell the truth to anything, because that's all part of the scheme. There isn't any child that's going to be born that we need to tell the truth to. Spirit doesn't have any separate creation that it could potentially tell the truth to that it's not separate. There isn't any such thing. Never will be. So the entire scheme, including testing out the defenses, including telling the truth, everything, suspended for an instant. We have the capacity to do that. Because we're spirit center of, we're all the center of our universe. There's something there. Suspended for an instant. And then, in that instant, what is there? What is there in that instant? Now, these defenses are still trying to destroy my life, absolutely. And I'm right in that situation that my life seems to be, you know, completely destroyed at this point. That's the defensiveness at work, but I'm going to suspend all of that. And also suspend my truth-telling for an instant. The whole scheme, everything frozen in place, just as it is. This is the answer. Freeze everything in place exactly as it is this moment, without going to the next moment. And then what is there? What is your experience there? This is called the full stop that the non-dualists talk about. And somehow, some have managed to apparently do that. But whether they've done it or not, we still have to do it ourselves. The real guru is the one that can bring you to that full stop, that makes you feel like, you know what, there is something there. Even in that full stop, there's something there, and you come to the full stop. So the whole scheme is much ado about absolutely nothing. And I have to further this explanation of the full stop in my own clarity here. But this morning it was pretty clear. I was able to just do a massive evaluation of is there anything that I think should not be stopped that's absolutely vital? Is there anything in this whole scheme that's absolutely vital? No. What? We need to perpetuate this fraud? We need to perpetuate this prank? Even truth-telling. We need to perpetuate even truth-telling to it. Really, if we can stop the whole thing for a moment, isn't that enough? You see, that's realization, whereas truth-telling is the testing out the defense systems of the situation. That's why the goddess doesn't want you to be enlightened. She wants you to continue to be truth-telling, but not stop the whole thing and find out what that's like. That's the difference between a truth teller and someone who's enlightened. Big difference. So, all of us, you know, need to shift from whatever we're doing into enlightenment, the holy instant. Every one of us. And you know, usually it's the truth tellers, not always, but usually it's the truth tellers who see through this whole scheme, because they're the ones that are getting used the worst by being told that they're here to tell truth and then just testing the defense systems out, and they realize, whoa, you know, this is terrible. What's going on here? And they start really, you know, saying, wow, what's the truth of this whole situation? Am I just being used? You know, but you can get it from any angle, actually, here. We're all just being used. Everyone's just being used. Totally. For nothing. For nothing at all. So since there is no child going to ever be born, all of this is for nothing. So why not suspend it for an instant? It doesn't have to come to any conclusion, does it? You can just all stop right now, just where it is. Stop in place, full stop in place, everything. All thought and consideration and reaction and planning, imagination, efforts, everything. Full stop right now. Concurrent, full concurrent stop right now. So the intellect says, well, what's going to be there? I'm trying to push that aside for the moment because I know something's going to be there. It's just in the back of my mind. I'm a little cloudy on it. It'll come. It'll clarify. Because I've been told many times by teachers what's there. What's important is to look and see in your mind, is there anything that you don't want to have stop? That you think, well, I got to keep this going on. Remember, if it's a full stop with everything, nothing needs anything then. There's no needs any right there. It was full stop. Everything's suspended. Time is suspended, temporarily suspended. What is there then in the suspension of time and space? What is there? The holy instant is the suspension of time, is this moment where everything is concurrently suspended. And then you know in the suspension of that, you know then what is there. And then no matter whether time and all this continues on then, you know that the stoppage of it doesn't matter because you know what's there in the stoppage of it. You've had that holy instant of enlightenment. Guru saying that all this fighting in World War II, for instance, it was Ananda Mai Ma said, all I see is two friends, two buddies playing a little game with each other. Like, what? He said, what are you talking about? The Russians, Germans are like killing each other like crazy. Everyone's killing each other. And she goes, I know, there's two friends having a game, playing a prank on each other, having some fun. What? That's what she saw. And it's true. Right? That's actually true. Because you're just testing defenses. There's this game going on where we're simulating. It's all a simulation, actually. This whole thing's just a simulation. Simulating conditions and then evaluating the conditions and then finding what we need to change in the conditions so that the eventual child, which doesn't exist, will never exist, We'll never suspect where it came from. We'll never suspect where it came from. So, really, everybody's complicit in all this. See how this bizarre, the whole thing works at this deep psychic level, you know, of imagination, spirit's imagination, where everything is coordinated and scripted. It's all scripted. The whole thing's scripted, actually. It's all scripted. It's all two-faced. It's all deception. So what's happening in this world, we don't quite realize it. It's stranger than fiction, for sure. Stranger than fiction. We're just working on this scenario, really, and testing out all the variables to it. So we want to provide the perfect cover story so that our offspring will never suspect that it's actually an extension of spirit. It will totally believe that it's a separate creation. And then we will believe that we're a new prime creator. See, Spirit says, I created something even God can't create. But it's all a ruse, you see. It's all deception. Anything we create is an extension of God, extension of God and Spirit. No matter what kind of cover story we have to say that convince it that it isn't. You cannot convince the truth that it's not true. It's impossible. Impossible. So there never will be such a separate creation. So all of this effort is in vain. It's useless. Including coming in here and testing out the defense systems. That's totally useless also. So the remedy is somewhere else. It's somewhere else. That's why teachers seem so strange. It is they don't seem to be really doing much of anything. They just, there's something like, you know, you just say, well, what's going on? How come you're not telling truth to everybody or something, and they're in the full stop. They know what's there with the full stop of all this. They're just saying, don't be afraid to experience this full stop. That's what has to be done. The whole thing has to stop concurrently. All of it. Suspended for an instant. And since we made space and time, we can suspend space and time. Certainly for an instant, and ultimately forever. I mean, so we can certainly suspend all space and time for an instant. As they, some say, the gap between thoughts, the gap between actions, the holy instant, you know, where before anything else happens in this whole universe, what is that? Before anything else happens, quicker than time and space, quicker than time encompassing all of space, before anything else happens at all, what is there? So you don't have to actually stop all this stuff, but you can be aware of what is there prior to anything happening whatsoever, including thoughts, reactions, thoughts, everything, the whole play of consciousness, before that play takes another infinitesimal step anywhere in the whole universe. What is there? What is there in that instant? So I guess you don't have to think of maybe suspending everything. It's that simply before anything else happens, what is there? Be aware of that. And we find out, apparently, that it's always there. It's like this block, solid block of reality, peace, just complete. It's always there. There's no gaps or seams in it. Time has not caused any gaps or seams at all. And all we're doing is just imagining this overlay upon it, upon being, imagining non-being overlaid by imagination over being. But it's really just not over it, but it's just, we're ignoring it. It's just this imagination of ignorance, of ignoring what is always there. So it's not an abyss, it's the opposite of abyss. It's complete, solid, seamless fullness is there. That's what the sages, saints, avatars, saviors, gurus, etc. tell us. So again, this is all seems stranger than fiction, but it is true. This is what's going on. I found out how I blocked money for my life, so I can be totally impoverished and be run down into complete destitution in my life, which is coming soon, actually, if I don't change things. As an intentional attempt to say, if someone comes here to tell the truth in the world, how to run them down into complete destitution so their message gets, you know, never gets delivered. This is actually the scheme, what's happening. I'm aware of it. This is the part of the defense structure, is to prevent any truth from ever getting to this child, imaginary child. So the child thinks it's a child of imagination, and living in this imaginary realm of impermanence and death, of non-being, living in the realm of non-being, and the truth never can ever reach it here. This is what we're trying to do. We're trying to create a hell, really, trying to create hell. All this is our efforts to create a great hell where truth can never penetrate it and never get to that child that we want to have born in hell. That believes hell is its creator. That's its home. And we keep testing out these defenses and then discarding. And the goddess just wants to discard me entirely. She says, okay, the goal is death for the truth tellers come here, is to drive them into ruination and suicide and death. That's the goal. So that they fail. The goal is failure for those who come to tell truth in this world. The purpose of the goddess is failure. And they'll do by hook or by crook, try to bring about failure. So two-faced. With one hand, she's saying, I want you to do your absolute very best to tell the truth that's so important to me. I want you to give 100% and be completely honest and tell the truth of this world. And then on the other hand, she's telling her other troops, Division 2, I want you to do everything possible at all costs to make this mission a failure. Make sure that he fails in his mission. Can be no success whatsoever. You must make him fail. And so she tells each side to give 100%. And then she's there evaluating how it works out, like the general sort of evaluating, okay. And then she goes, okay, well, he's able to get this far and do this much. Okay, so we need to strengthen our defenses, sort of block him from even being able to do that. You know, that kind of thing. That's what's taking place. Now, who's being lied to? Well, the truth teller is the one who's being deceived, because the defensive systems, they know that the goddess is telling this one, because she says, look, I'm telling this guy to give 100% and be a truth teller, and he's coming. I'm telling you he's coming, so I want you to have all your defenses ready to stop him. So they know that she told, you know, like for instance, told me to give 100% here to try to tell the truth. They already know that defense structure. Their job is to prevent it. That's what's going on. Whereas I'm kept in the dark about these defenses that the goddess is actually sponsoring the spirit in the guise of this, you know, in a believable form, right? The goddess seems so believable. You suspend your disbelief is the problem. She convinces you to give, oh, you gotta give 100% for me, you know, you're saving my child, you're so important, blah, 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 blah. Every kind of thing under the sun, she tells you, to convince you to give it your very best. Instead of saying, well, I might say, nah, you know, I think this is all a scam. Why should I play into this and burn myself out and just be used like this? Well, I don't want to do that. You know, she said, oh, no, you got to do it. She tried to convince you to do it. So the spiritual path really is to get immunity from that and say, no, I'm not playing that game. What I want to do is I just want to, before anything else happens in the entire existence of this universe and all of my imagination, before anything else happens, what is there before anything else happens? This very instant. What is there this very instant? Before any truth-telling, before any defenses against truth-telling, before any birth of a child or non-birth of a child, thoughts, aspirations, hopes, actions of all types, movements, whatever. Before any of that happens, from this instant, from the past to the future, before any of that happens, this very instant, before even the slightest motion even happens, any motion at all, in the instant before you can even say there's any motion at all, what is there? What is there? What is present? Ah, that helicopter buzzing me. I could just ride over the treetops here, right over the treetops, exactly right over this where I'm taping now. I'm outside, just completely, just buzzing me like that. Oh my God. Interesting, huh? Interesting. So there are a lot of tortured truth tellers around the world, for sure. There are a lot of people. Everyone's been used in this situation. Everybody has been used. Now, I know there's some people who I've come across who seem completely intractable to the truth. And they just waste my time. This is also by design. This is part of the defensive structure. Is can we develop someone who's so resistant to truth that no matter what you tell them, they won't listen? But they're being used too. They're being told to condition themselves to be so stupid an intractable truth that no matter what you tell them, they don't have a clue what you're talking about and can't respond at all. And so I've seen that they literally give 100% to condition themselves to be stupid. 100%. And that's a terrible thing, isn't it? They're just being used to become incredibly intractable and stupid and resistant to any truth. And so they're being tested out to see, okay, how intractable are they? And they're just being used too. Everyone's just being used here for this mission. Impossible mission. Mission impossible. Convince the extension of spirit that it's a separate will and that it has no being, it has no eternal life, and that it knows nothing about truth or nothing about its true origins, and it's convinced, 100% convinced forever, that its origins are this time and space. That's mission impossible. We're all being used from the very beginning. So actually it is conceivable, possible, for those who are playing the role of complete stupidity, for them to wake up too. Because they see that if they see that it's been even used and the whole thing's impossible, they say, I don't need to be stupid anymore. That's ridiculous. Let me just see this holy instant right now before anything else, before anything happens at all in this, the next step in this, all of this. Before anything happens next, what is there present? So you really could wake up from any angle that where you are, from any angle where you are, the holy instant is available to you. This remedy is available to you. And you can recognize you've been used. Everyone is being used in existence, totally. Spirit's just using itself on an impossible quest. Nothing that is taking place here is necessary. Nothing. Zero necessity to it. Zero necessity. So everyone's just being used for nothing, for no necessity whatsoever. So at any point, anybody can recognize this, even if you're playing the role of being totally stupid. See, I'm playing the role of being totally smart. Others are playing the role of being totally stupid. But I'm not totally smart. If I was, I'd accept the holy instant, if I see. Yeah. But I'm wising up to the situation. So it's not true that these real dense, dullard people can't be saved. Because they can realize too that they're just playing a role of being the dense dullard. See, nothing has to happen. The whole instant, everything's before anything else happens. Nothing has to happen then. So whatever role you were playing, it becomes totally irrelevant at that point because you're only seeing what is beyond all roles. What is beyond all roles in this scheme? What is indifferent to all these roles that have been played? What is totally indifferent to it? What is it that's not caught up in all this? So anyone can... I see that from any viewpoint, the holy instant. Doesn't matter how stupid you've been, or how dense, or how smart, or whatever. All is equal. And that's all unnecessary. So fundamentally, it's not true that it's interesting. It's not true that you have to be a certain person or a certain path and you have to advance, etc. That's not entirely true. It's... But the thing is that to see, to recognize it just being used is very difficult and does require to matter, even if you're very dense and dull. But it's possible that even the demons, the dense, dull, hideous people who are being used in that role to defend against truth, you know, and to make this world seem utterly opposite of reality, so the child will have no inkling where it came, really came from. That they can be just as tired and feel they're being just as used as anyone else, actually. And they can say, you know what, I'm so tired of being a demon or something, a devil. The devil says, I'm so tired of being the devil. This is such a scam, you know. There is no child ever going to be born. This is all for nothing. It's all useless. What do I do? What do I do? Holy instant. Before anything else, have the whole thing concurrently suspended, as it were, timeless. A timeless instant where nothing is happening. And then they experience what is beyond this whole scheme. And they say, ah, I'm free of the whole thing. I'm free of the whole thing. Absolutely. Absolutely. There's no reason at all why that can't happen. And so this is the real truth. The real truth, you see. This is the truth that gets through to all of us. It has nothing to do with this child. There is no child. It's, we're all suckers. We've all been playing the fool. We've all been playing the fool. No matter what role we're playing the fool. So those deepest, darkest trolls, you know, the dark, you know, terrible, horrible people who are trying to put on, they're playing this costume, wearing the costume of this hideousness, you know, darkness, darkest darkness. They're just being used too, entirely, to say, okay, this is what I need to do to fashion a situation, a scenario that the child will never suspect, where it's a child of light, you know, where it came from. They're just being used because there is no child. There's no child, and they're not doing it for themselves. They're not saying, hey, I want to hang out in this deep, dark hell. No child of God wants to do that. No one. But they've been conned, this whole scheme, seduced into thinking that once the child is born and accepts this, that they will then be liberated from their roles and live in even greater bliss than before, you know, in reality. Be greater than God. So they're thinking, well, the ones wearing the demon costume, and just one more day of this, you know, and I'm sure the child will be born, finally, as they're schlepping along. And they said, I'm so tired of wearing this, you know, ogre costume. So tired of it. Just as the truth tellers are so tired of wearing this costume of so-called, quote-unquote, light or something, you know. They're so tired of that, too. Because they want to experience the real light, you know. Just like the ogre wants to experience the real light. The real light of being. It's not the light of time and space. I'm so tired of wearing this costume of the light of time and space. So, you know, the equal feeling of the deepest, darkest ogre and the lightest, brightest, time and space lightest truth teller, they're both equally exhausted and fed up with this stupid role playing. No child of God wants to be caught up in role playing. But we're doing it because we think it's going to lead to a new creation. And again, as I said in the previous video, we have this magical belief that once the simulation becomes realistic enough, then that will automatically cause the birth of the child. It'll be that's, we've completely invented this dynamic, which God never created. There is no such dynamic. It's impossible. It'll never take place. But we keep justifying ourselves to ourselves that as soon as we keep this mirage is made realistic enough and dark enough and scary and terrible and doesn't remind us of reality at all, and no truth teller can get through, then the child will be born automatically. Not true. No child will ever be born. So we just, you know, put on that ogre costume one more day and say, ah, maybe today's the day that'll finally, you know, and it just goes on and on. So the quote-unquote dark side and the quote-unquote light side, the good and the bad, are equally tired of this whole charade. Totally equally tired of the whole charade. And it actually is possible that the whole thing could end. The whole thing could come to an end without anything needing to take place. And in fact, each one can experience that end to the whole thing, the end of time and space, right now, without anything else taking place at all. Before the next teardrop falls, right? Before the next teardrop falls, what is there? Behind all of this this scam, this scheme, this prank, this joke. But Jesus said he came to save the sinners, and not all the righteous Pharisees and these Sadducees and all these kind of stuff. I think they said, no, they come to save the sinners. What is he talking about? The ones who are really tired of their role, you know. Whatever their role has been. Good, bad, dark, light, whatever. All of these roles were just designed to try and custom design a mirage. Remember, that was so realistic it could never be seen through. And there's all these different roles, so many, 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 many different roles. So I'm starting to wear down a little here. Now this is heavy stuff. But again and again and again we're told this holy instant is the answer. What is there? Are we willing to experience without any role playing at all for the next step of any role playing? Full stop, total universe, the whole scheme, full stop. Just what is there? What is there? We need to experience that. What is there? Turn our attention to that. But it helps for us to understand why we're turning our attention to that. Not just to feel good, but we need to do that so we're not trapped in these roles, these terrible roles, whether good or bad, if I'm smart, playing stupid. I've realized that people are just playing stupid. I've realized that. All these people who think they seem real stupid, it's a pretense. They're in a role. They're playing a role. Everyone's just playing a role here. What is it that's beyond roles? What is it behind roles? What if we didn't need any roles? What would there be? And it's interesting, there was this roll on the table last night. And it looked really good. I know what it tastes like. And I said, maybe I'm going to eat some of that roll. And I said, no. I'll leave the roll alone. I'm going to leave the roll alone. Literally, there was this very tasty Asiago cheese and onion roll there. Or Asiago, whatever. And I said, forget it. I'm not going to eat that roll. I'm on a diet from roll. So we're gonna go on a roll-free diet, a roll-free diet. Stop our rolls. Let all rolls stop. Good, bad. So I won't be trying to tell truth to stupid people, and stupid people won't try to be stupid towards truth tellers, and the good won't try to liberate shine light into the bad, dark, and the darkness won't try to obfuscate the light, and all these polarity game, the whole polarity game, all these roles suspended for an instant. Nothing is taking place in this role, and as far as roles go, nothing. And so that's what we're going towards. We can just look at this and say, okay, this is my goal now. Okay, now what is it that is going to be experienced? It's not a role. It's not a role. It's not a role. What is beyond roles? What is beyond schemes? What is beyond pranks? What is beyond jokes? What is there underlying all this that doesn't require any of this joke and scheme, etc., for it to be what it is? It's not demanding that we continue on with this. What is that? Omnipresence. Yeah, we can look at this. What is it that's completely untouched by all these schemes, one way or the other? It's completely indifferent to it. But by seeing this, experiencing this divine indifference, we realize, hey, we don't need to keep doing this. God's not going to punish us if we stop doing this. This indifference is not going to change if I stop this. But it's a divine indifference, not like a dislike or something. It is simply that it's saying, you know what, I'll support you no matter what you do. You're supported no matter what. That is the feeling. When I got the glimpse of the holy instant, the vision of oneness, you are supported no matter what. Always. Total support to you. Like you are my child forever. Total support, like a parent saying, you will always be totally supported. When I say the indifference, I mean it's that no matter what you do, you are totally supported. Even if you try to put yourself into this role, try to scheme this total prank on yourself, you're still totally supported. But you're also totally supported if you drop this too. This is what needs to be experienced. The support beyond anything that we could ever think or imagine of doing. It's prior to that and beyond that. It's always beyond. The support always extends beyond anything we could ever imagine doing or experiencing. So I hope this video has given a sort of a opening the door upon a option here that maybe we haven't clearly considered enough yet. Maybe I don't have any work this week, so I'm able to work on this stuff, you know, because it's very important stuff here. Okay, so I can get this up on.